Good morning, this is B. Naresh, working as assistant professor in EC department. So today we are going to perform a frequency response of CS amplifier. So in this experiment, we are going to observe the frequency response of a common source amplifier using JFET.
So this is a circuit diagram for common source amplifier here. So here this BFW11 is a model for JFET. And the input side, we are going to apply 50 millivolts peak-to-peak voltage with a 1 kHz frequency, and the capacitance is a 10 nanofarads here. And the input side, the resistance is for the across the gate terminal, it is represented as 10 mega ohms. And drain side, it requires the drain resistance is 3.3 kilo ohms. And the source side, the resistance is 150 ohms along with the parallel capacitance is 100 microfarad here. And across this gate terminal, we are going to connect a 10 microfarad capacitor. At the end of this 10 microfarad capacitor, we are going to observe the output voltage here. And this drain resistance is biasing through the biasing voltage that is represented as 15 volts here. So according to the circuit diagram, now we are going to make the connections by using the multisim software here. So first click on this multisim software. So it opens like this. So here in this breadboard, we are going to place the components. For this case, first to choose the components, choose this place button and choose this component here. So in that component, where the group database group is there, this is the master database. In a group, we are going to select a transistors. So in the transistor, you select this JFET-N, and here you select a model number is BFW11, then select OK. So by using the left cursor, you can place anywhere here. Then it copies the component in that breadboard, then again it opens the component window here. So here now we are going to select the resistors. To select the resistors, then in that group you choose this basic. In that basic you choose the resistor. Then here type your required values here. So as per given circuit diagram, we required a 10 mega ohms resistor. So then select this 10 mega ohms resistor and place somewhere. Then again, we also required a 3.3 kilo ohms resistor. Then type your 3.3k search. Then select OK and copy here. Then again, a 150 ohms resistor is also required. Select this 150. Select OK. Then now we are going to choose the capacitor. In that group, again you select this capacitor. In that capacitor, you choose the required capacitance values here. So first, we require 10 nanofarads here. And type 10 and small n. Select OK. Then copy somewhere. Then a 10 microfarad is also required here. Then choose OK. Again, 100 microfarad is also required. Then select OK here. Then we require some input voltage. For this case, in that group, you select the sources. In that, you select the signal voltage source. So here in this, you select AC voltage. Then select OK. Then we need to make the common terminal, that is nothing but a ground terminal. For this case, you choose power sources. In this power sources, choose this ground. Select OK. Then a biasing voltage VDD is required. So in that same group, we choose this VDD. Select OK and copy here. So after choosing all the components as per given circuit, then close this component window. Now we need to alter the components as per the given circuit. Then we can arrange some order here. So first this is the input, then capacitor is required, and this is the transistor, and the 3.3 is across the drain side. So here I'm going to rotate this one. So if you want to rotate any component, select that component and click the right button. Choose this rotate 90 degrees clockwise. Then VDD is connected here. Then this input side is 10 mega ohms also I'm going to rotate. Then this 150 ohms is connected to across the source. So I'm placing nearby source. This 100 microfarad is parallel with this 150 ohms here. Then this 10 microfarad is across the output side here. So common source means source is a common for input side and the output side here. And output is taken across the drain terminal here. And here this is the drain terminal. And this is the source. And this is the gate terminal here. Now we need to make the connections. So if you want to make a connection between one component and another component, move the cursor and just hold the left cursor where we need to start the connection. Just drag from that point to your connecting point. Just leave the button here. So hence a connection is established between one node to the another node. So like this we need to make all the connections as per given circuit here. So and this 10 mega ohms one terminal is connected to gate, and this drain is connected to 3.3 kilo ohms. 3.3 kilo ohms is connected to VDD, and the source is connected to 150 ohms. This 100 microfarad is also connected to parallel with 150 ohms. Then this 10 microfarad positive terminal is connected across the drain. This 10 microfarad is connected to drain terminal here. Then again one more device is required to measure the output. So for this case we require a oscilloscope here, and that device can be used to identify the graphical response as well as to observe the graphical response with respect to your given input signal here. And from that response we need to observe the output voltage, then how much gain should be amplified, how much gain should be occurred here. So to select this oscilloscope in the right side, so this meter shows multimeter, and this meter is the function generator, and this one is the wattmeter, and this is oscilloscope. So select this oscilloscope, place in this breadboard screen. Then so it contains the two channels, channel A and the channel B here. I'm going to make the channel A positive is connected across the output node, and channel B, so we are going to observe output signal with respect to input signal. Hence I'm going to make the connections input as well as the output here. So here the channel B is used to absorb your input signal here. So hence it is connected to input node here. Remaining all the terminals should be connected to ground potential here. Hence I started with the source. So this source negative terminal is connected to ground, and this R1 is also connected to ground. 150 ohms is also connected to ground. This capacitor is also connected to ground. Then this channel A negative is also connected to ground, and channel B negative is also connected to ground. Then here I'm going to modify the channel colors to easily recognize the which one is the input and which one is the output here. If you observe this channel A and channel B positive wise, both are represented with the red color. So to differentiate this input and output, here I'm going to modify the color of any channel, either channel A or channel B. So here I am going to modify the channel B color. If you want to modify the color, select that particular line, then right click here, choose the segment color. In that you can choose any one color. So here I am going to choose the blue color, then select OK here. So means it indicates that the blue color line shows the input signal, the red color line shows the output signal here. And one more modification here. So here the biasing voltage for this JFET is required 15 volts. Hence, to change this biasing voltage, double click on this VDD. Now you can change this 5 volts to required voltage. So here the required biasing voltage is 15 volts. Hence, I adjusted to 15 volts. Then select OK here. Then input side, we need to apply a 50 millivolts input signal. Hence, so here this is the peak voltage here, hence here we need to write 25 millivolts and the frequency is the 1 kilohertz. Then you set this for select OK. So this is 25 millivolts peak, means peak to peak is 50 millivolts with a 1 kilohertz signal here. So after this, all these connections, now we need to run the common source amplifier. We need to observe the frequency response here. So to simulate this one, choose FI or this run button. Just click on that run button. Then here we need, by using this oscilloscope, we are going to observe the output signal. For this case, just double click this oscilloscope. Then so to change this channel A and channel B scaling factors, for example, we are applying less input voltage here, and channel B is also I am going to modify. Then time period to adjust the scale here for clear visibility of your graphical response. Then after this adjustment, just to stop the simulation, pause button or F6, then you can now observe. So here the blue color wave is indicates as a input signal, and the red color signal is indicates as a output waveform here. So in a common source amplifier, we know that as per the theoretical knowledge, we know that it has the output is always 180 degrees phase shift with respect to your input signal. So you can observe here that 180 degrees phase shift. If our input is a positive peak going, output is negative peak going. When input is a negative peak going, then output is your positive peak going. And here you can also observe the output signal is amplified with respect to your input signal here. So now from this response, we need to note down the output voltage. To observe this output voltage, then just click on this window here and choose the selected trace. So here output is connected. So here I connected output is across the channel A. So I select the channel A, select OK. Just move these traces from which point to which point. We need to identify the amplitude. So vertically we need to measure the amplitude from the peak to peak. So this is the maximum positive peak and this is maximum negative peak. Just make these two traces at the two ends of the peaks, then I'll identify this one. So channel A, what is the output voltage, shows 524.211 millivolts here, but input signal is 49.7, approximately it is 50 millivolts. For a given 50 millivolts input signal, output voltage is 524.2 millivolts here. So then after this, we need to identify the output voltage for a different frequencies here. So from that, we need to calculate the gain, and then we need to plot the response of this common source amplifier here. So for this case, before going to change any new frequency, first we need to stop the simulation by using this red button. Then if you want to change this frequency, just double click on this input source. So here we are going to apply the frequency ranges from 100 Hz to 1 MHz here. So we can apply 1 mega, 100 MHz, 500, sorry, 100 Hz, 500 Hz, 1 kilo, 10 kilo, 50 kilo, like that 100 kilo. So up to we need to apply the 1 MHz here or 100 MHz. Then we need to note down the corresponding output voltage here. Suppose initially I'm applying the 100 Hz, just change the frequency to 100 Hz, select OK. Then after this, just you simulate here. Then you can observe. Then we need to observe this time base for a clear response here. Now you can check it. Again, it shows that 180 degrees phase shift. Then stop this one here. Then just move this like this. Then again, you choose this select trace for channel A and adjust the traces. Positive maximum peak and one should be adjusted to negative maximum peak. Then note down this corresponding output voltage. What is the corresponding output voltage? 520.4 millivolts here. So this is V0, output voltage V0, and input voltage is always constant. In a tabular column, we need to note down the, we need to change the frequencies. At that particular frequency, we need to observe the output voltage here, V0 here. So after this, then can modify the new frequency, 100 Hz to some new frequency. First, before going to change this frequency, stop this simulation. Then double click this input signal. Now change this 100 Hz to suppose 500 Hz. Then select OK. Then again run this one. Then observe you. So then again you stop this. Then by using the same principle, you choose the phase for the channel A. Then adjust these two traces from the maximum positive peak to maximum negative peak. Then note down the corresponding output voltage, that is 523.5 millivolts here, the given 50 millivolts here. So like this, we need to apply the different frequencies, then note down the corresponding output voltage here. So after this, after observation of all the output voltages with respect to your frequency, different frequencies here, then we need to calculate the gain here. So we know that generally the gain is defined as with the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage here. So for every frequency, we need to observe the gain. Then again, we need to convert the gain in terms of your decibels. So by using that frequency and the gain in decibels, we need to plot the frequency response for this common source JFET amplifier or a CS JFET amplifier here. So thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.